r/AskReddit. What legal thing would you ban if you could? Unknown fees added right before you pay. Cough ticket master cough. Bought a prepaid debit card. Turns out there's a $1 to $2 fee on every purchase. That $1 candy bar I bought turned out to be $3. Like WTF. Okay, this is the one that ducks with my mind the most. That's scummy. Vending machines that take credit cards adding a dollar to the price for processing. Still only lets you get one item at a time. Those stickers that when you try to peel it off it leaves most of it stuck on. TJ Maxx, king of awful stickers in the worst places. I believe they purposely use cheap stickers for loss prevention. I knew a few people who would swap the clearance sticker of a $3 shirt with one from a $25 shirt and the cashier would scan it without batting an eye. Kinda hard to do that if the sticker won't come off in one piece. Or maybe they're just cheap. P. I work at Home Goods, sister store to TJ Maxx under the same company TJX, and we all use the same types of stickers. We have a huge loss prevention problem. People swap stickers on literally everything. I'm talking differences under a dollar. Some of our highest theft departments are sheets, mirrors, wall decor, and furniture. The labels, sticky tags, have these weird perforations all around and through them to make it obvious when someone has taken one off and put it on something else. Of course, it's not that hard to get around it if people actually looked at the department number and didn't switch obviously wrong tickets. That is, I can tell this leaning mirror isn't a $5 item from the healthy food department. That kind of shit drive me crazy. I work at Jmaxx and the other day someone tried to get a pair of men's 79.99 jeans with an 8.00 clearance tag from the woman's department. Selling customers' information. This made headlines up here in Canada a while ago. Shaw won the right to sell customer info from the government, and that other companies would soon follow suit. Made my ducking blood boil. Too lazy to solve the problem, so they just legalized it. Ducking disgusting. Why sell the info when you can give it away? That's what we do here in the US. See Equifax. Junk mail. Especially when it's not even addressed to you. Just to our neighbor or to our friends at. Yeah, it just goes to the garbage recycling. Not useful at all. Probably won't ever happen. The postal service needs that large volume of mail to produce enough revenue to help keep the service running. Restaurants, bars not listing the price of alcoholic beverages on the menu. I operate under the assumption that when the price isn't on the menu, I cannot afford this place. It's always expensive rip-off places that do it. Yup, if you have to ask, you can't afford it. I mean, I could afford a single drink at most places. It just comes down to if I want to actually spend such an absurd amount on said drink. Ads that suddenly get loud for no reason. Auto-playing videos. Also radio ads involving distracting sounds, especially things like car horns. Yeah, I honestly wouldn't be mad if car horns and emergency vehicle sirens were banned from public radio airwaves. It can be incredibly distracting looking for the fire truck or ambulance that you hear but can't see. Commercials with ringing doorbells, especially from online pet supply shops, who should damn well know better. Somewhat related to this is sirens being used in songs. Really dangerous when driving. Buttford. Maybe it shouldn't be illegal, but there was one with the sound of an alarm clock that jolted my brain out of what I was doing and made my heart jump every time. For profit prisons. But then how will we ever get Dead Man Wonderland IRL? US advertising of prescription drugs. I think medical self-advocacy is good, but I can't imagine people's health outcomes are improved when they beg their doctors for a prescription for some drug they heard about on TV or a website banner ad, instead of having the professionals, whom they are paying for this service, decide whether a given drug is a good choice for treating the problem. From a UK perspective, it's insane that prescription drugs can be advertised on TV. Over here, some people might ask their doctor for a drug they've heard of, but I think the majority of people would take what their doctor told them to take. Have you ever seen the ads? They are not just ads but manipulative as hell. Pretty lady. Happy old dude. Playing with the dog or the kids. Swimming maybe. Happy music. Cheery voice. Ask your doctor about Zithenolpal. More happy scenes and music. Subdued fast talking voice side effect may include death. depression, loose stools. Do not take xathinolpal if you are allergic to xathinolpal. Pregnant, may become pregnant, male, female, human, or a dog. Cheery voice, xathinolpal, for making you better, for like 4 minutes. It's bad enough it's advertised. They are probably at the top of skeevy scam sounding ads. And that includes the pillow guy who got sued and lost for his pillow ads being misleading. Follow 2 months later by, do you or someone you know suffer from the known side effects of a popular advertised drug? Call Scummy Layers now for the money you are owed. Ads that ask you to subscribe to some sort of newsletter within 5 seconds of viewing a web page. Why would I subscribe to a site that does that? I can't even see the content I'm subscribing to. The ad is blocking the whole ducking page. Want to get me to close the website and never come back? Because that's how you get me to close the website and never come back. I've beached about this on Twitter directly to a few sites that did it, but that were small enough to respond to a quick Twitter message. So not like CNN. The responses I got back from all of the site operators indicated that the conversion rate for content obscuring subscribe to our shit PLZ newsletter popovers is ludicrously high. I was ducking gobsmacked. Apparently the answer to who the duck would respond positively to duckery like this is lots and lots of people. Internet service providers being able to throttle your internet. When it goes slow they flip a couple of switches and all of a sudden you're back to a proper speed, only to realize a week later you're back where you started. Duck you, CenturyLink. Civil forfeiture. Same with criminal, until a conviction. Even after a conviction, the only assets forfeited are what is ordered as punishment by the judge, not at the police's discretion. This should be way higher. It is straight up robbery. I'm an officer and I completely agree that civil asset forfeiture is immoral, unjust, and should be illegal. P.S. Before I get blown up, I have never participated in civil asset forfeiture thanks to the fact of my job location and description. Those bright blue headlights. They blind the absolute hell out of me. There have been a few times somebody has been riding with them on bright and it intensified their usual brightness, so I've had to stop my car just so I don't potentially run off the road or hit somebody. Improperly aligned headlights too. There are standards for how high the light should project from certain distances. And I've seen some that are so far off. Even in my truck they are blinding. Can't imagine if I were in a car. No tolerance policies in schools. I fell short of them as a child and now as a teacher I still disagree with them. There are always exceptions. All zero tolerance policies are good for is getting someone suspended for getting punched. They also don't scale well for offenses. So once you figure you're getting punished anyways, you may as well go all out. This is why they don't give you life in prison for attempted murder. Wow, I never thought of it that way. Look up the Dazhexiang Uprising. That's basically the whole reason behind a significant Chinese rebellion, when the penalty for being late was death. Free trials that don't cancel after the trial is up, but start charging your card since you forgot about it. That's why they invented debit gift cards. I've been nailed by this, so now I create a calendar reminder on my phone to alert me when the cancellation date is approaching. Equifax. At the very least, the credit bureaus should be required to explain exactly how your credit rating is derived. It's complete bullshit that we don't really have a complete understanding of how it's calculated. Is that how it works in the US? They give a score to lenders and they basically have a criteria that says if over this score then yes, if not no. In the UK at least they just provide information to the lenders and they have their own criteria for deciding whether to lend or not. The infamous credit scores these guys charge for are meaningless other than to provide a guide of where you stand compared to everyone else. Puppy mills. Extend that to all kinds of mass pet production. Not just puppy mills, but any animal that goes through similar things. Guinea pigs are notoriously overbred, especially Abyssinians. Who are dumped in your local pet store if they don't have perfect knots? Most of these pigs get hardly any attention. Though it's not nearly as bad as the way puppy mills mistreat dogs. How much is this medical procedure going to cost me? Well, we don't really know, but you're obligated to pay all of whatever we decide it to be. My husband just had surgery that we were told would be around $5,000. It was $24,000. A bill to mandate transparency in medical pricing would actually go a long way to solving our healthcare costs. Surprisingly, hospitals and insurers are adamantly opposed. Imagine that. Ticketmaster outrageous charges. $40 tickets plus $25 service and convenience fees. Beach, I serviced myself and you provided no extra convenience. I am not at a concert right now because hours ago, I saw, $40. Cool, processing. Total, $61.50. So I noped out. It was a $40 show and maybe $5.08 of fees I expected. You're not increasing the price on me by half from the sticker price. Duck you, TM. What essentially amounts to legalized bribery from corporations in Washington. Paparazzi, it's literally legal stalking. Like following people around and taking pictures without their consent? How is that okay? I was really confused when this crotch picture of Paris Hilton was shot. The media talked about what a shameless horse she is for not wearing a slip. I think taking the picture was wrong. Making it public was worse. When Emma Watson turned 18, the paparazzi literally lay down on the sidewalk to take pictures up her skirt. Those pictures were covers of British tabloids the next day. Overdraft fees. You went 4.37 negative into your checking account. You're obviously not well off. Let us help you out by charging you another $40. I feel that. One time I didn't notice the overdraft fee and they charged me a second overdraft fee. My only bank would charge you a $20 fee if you did not have more than $100 in your account come the end of the month. Well, the $20 fee overdrafted me then gave me a $40 overdraft fee. I quickly closed that account and never used that bank again. Cost-based or religion-based allocation favorism. It's a very big problem in India. Child marriage. Not even if the parents consent. Kids don't know what they're getting into. And often they're forced into them after something the family finds shameful. Like an unplanned pregnancy or rape. They almost got banned in New Jersey but Chris Christie vetoed it. Last year a Girl Scout in New Hampshire learned that girls could legally be married as young as 13. She petitioned to have the age raised to 16. And it went before the state legislature. They struck it down because there could be reasons a family would want to see their daughter married at 13. Yep, bullshit reasons. Litter in general, but especially cigarette butts. In Australia they are everywhere. In lots of places littering is already illegal and subject to fines. Unnecessary processed sugar in food items that don't need it. Ticket companies who buy out all the tickets in 10 minutes and sell them 50x the price. How about bots that buy up all of something to artificially inflate prices by hoarding all of the merchandise? I guess it's the same thing. Walking too slow in front of me and me only. Not just that. Not even walking slowly. No. The real enemy is that one person who walks just a tad slower than you. But still at a nearly acceptable pace. It's slow enough to where you might want to pass. But so fast that you'd need to almost jog to overtake them. So you're walking along to that. Guy's minding his own business. But you're back there wondering whose dong you have to suck to make the suffering end. Pyramid schemes, multi-level marketing. Why do I have to pay extra to pay my bills online? Just let me pay my bills. Hurting used chewing gum on roads, and under desks and chairs. Political attack ads. Tell me why I should vote for you, not why I shouldn't vote for your opponent. Being able to pollute the air and water just by paying a fee. Talking in movie theaters while the movie is playing. Talk all you want when the ads are playing, but as soon as the movie starts you need to shut the duck up. Scientology. Sirens and music on the radio. There is a radio station in my city that intentionally plays siren and horn noises and it's pure evil. Not passing in the passing lane. That can be more dangerous than speeding. Salt Lake cops put the hammer down on so-called Mormon roadblocks. Wherein self-righteous douches would drive side by side enforcing the speed limit. It was a few years ago, but it was gratifying to have the law tell those folks off. Fake pregnancy tests that are supposed to say positive. That's just wrong. Apps that pause or lower your music. Whoa, You made it to the end, you're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.